Welcome to the Shikama Live Show with your host, Shikama. It is Saturday. Today is my big day, but I'm still sick, so... And no, I don't want to go to the doctor and get tested to see if I have the pandemic, but YouTube sent me a check for $200 as my monthly paycheck without any explanation, and all of their people are out of the office, so nobody can explain what's going on. They simply have a thing that says that they're not in the office, and... So I'm $500 down, so if just 5 of you, no, 10 of you donate $50, or 25 of you donate $20, or 50 of you donate $10, I'd be okay. I'll leave the links to how to donate to the channel in the information box and the description. I think I have a doozy. This is good research, and I believe it's going to settle some history and some myths and some conspiracies that have been just hiding in plain sight. What you don't know is that there are people who are dedicating their lives to making sure that this information does not get out. Why it's so important to them, I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know why. I can guess why, but is it so important to hide history? Now, a lot of you all have asked me to do historical things, and here we are. I have the most quintessential historical secret in the United States. Abraham Lincoln was the first black president. Now, I'm going to give you my opinion and the historical facts. Some people believe this, but I don't. Oh, it's not that I don't believe Lincoln wasn't black. He was definitively black, but I know he wasn't the first black president. But I'll leave that up for another video or for you to discover, or if you want me to do an entire video on who the first black president was. It's a pretty strange tale. I'll do that if you leave a comment and say that's what you want to see. No, Lincoln was definitely black, or like Barack Obama and six other U.S. presidents, Lincoln was a mixture that included black. Now, notice I didn't say biracial. Biracial is a term that black and white people have come up with to deny the accepted term black, because the general public doesn't accept anyone mixed with black to be anything other than black. Obama is considered black, although his mother was fully white. And here's a controversy worse than biracial people. Biracial usually means black plus some other form of Caucasian, if you take the strict definition to mean all other groups that are not black, meaning there's black and then there's not, or the rest of the world, right? Outside of the continent that we named Africa, which is a white man's name, has nothing to do with the actual people that live on that continent. Bi means two. Now, what if I introduce to you a new term that is older than dirt? Melungeon. Here's the problem. There is a group that is dedicated to expunging and eradicating all concepts of Melungeon. On one side of the debate are the Society of the Observation of Melungeons as an entirely new racial group. And then there are the Anti-Melungeons. I'm pretty sure you didn't know that this even existed. Now, the Anti-Melungeons have been very successful in expunging the entire notion that the word even exists. How many of you even know the word existed before I even told it to you? Elvis Presley was a Melungeon. He's a very famous racist, but when you expose that he was a Melungeon, it puts an embarrassing perspective to him. For some reason, humans don't like Melungeons, because they also tend to create the best humans. So for strict definition, a Melungeon is a person born with three distinct racial groups, if you believe the whole Caucasian, Africanoid, Mongoloid, Mongoloid, and then whatever Native American is considered. Native or Pacific Islander, whatever you consider that, or whatever that racial group is considered. So for strict definition, a Melungeon is a person with three distinct racial groups, always including black. So Lincoln was black plus white plus some other Native American. I want to say Cherokee, but I'm not definite on that. And supposedly Cherokee is a made up thing, and that's not what they actually used to call themselves. They may call themselves Cherokee today, but that's not what they used to call them. That's not what they were originally called. Fun fact there. If you want me to look into that, leave a comment below. When you then discover that Lincoln was Jewish white, then you realize a whole bunch of things and why his life was the way it was. The denial that he was Jewish was so strong. And then on top of that, the claim that he was Melungeon didn't stand a chance. This need for all U.S. presidents to be considered white was so strong. It's still so strong. I mean, to this day, they're not gonna go back and say, oh, by the way, all the U.S. presidents were not all white. That some of the president's relatives were hidden or even assassinated to make sure no one found out. That's as recent as the 1950s, I want to say. A medical team seeking historical proof that Lincoln had several diseases, who were given the green light to go extract the DNA from his presidential library, were denied at the very last minute when the Genealogy Society was invited along with them to participate in the DNA study. For the record, Jewish scholars not only claim Lincoln is Jewish, but also point out his features as being stereotypically Sephardic Jewish. Now, why does no one talk about Melungeons anymore? Biracial is still around. The reason is, once you start realizing that Melungeons exist, people who are considered white start to disappear. And the idea that black people have contributed nothing to society falls apart. Now, the whole idea that black people have contributed nothing to society, while of course an obvious lie, the thing is, it's one thing to deny a fully black man didn't invent, or black men didn't invent 90% of the common things that we use today in our homes. But it is a whole nother ballgame when you start believing in the existence of Melungeons and not calling them white people, and seeing that all of their inventions are then also ascribed to black people, because that's what would happen. Once you start calling white people Melungeon, you know, some people are going to say, well, it's the one drop rule. You got one drop of black in you, you are considered black. Then all of the inventions the Melungeons invented are now considered black, because that's the way the United States is. It might not be how the whole world is, but that's how the United States is. And 90% of you who are going to watch this video are from the United States. So it'll be like this. This guy you thought was white turns out to be black, for lack of a better term. And so does the other million white guys. I want you to listen to this part. And we know how people in 2020 love to hate on white guys. What if it turned out that all of those white guys were actually Melungeon? Which is quite probable. I heard a stat that said that 80% of black Americans, the people that we call black Americans or African Americans, are mixed with white. And 60% of white people that we considered white in the United States are mixed with black somewhere in their ancestry. So the idea that a lot of people that we're calling white and saying, oh, but you're just a white male, are actually Melungeon, is the probability of it is quite high, to the tune of 60% of the time you're dealing with a Melungeon. You're not dealing with a white person. My neighbor, 74-year-old woman, white woman, I mean, just a white as snow, the whole nine yards, right? The very first thing she said to me was, well, I have black in me. I don't know what she went on to say. I can't keep track of what she says, because she'll talk to you for about an hour if you say hello. Love her to death, though. She's quite nice. She's the only one who checks up on me to make sure I'm still alive. So it's quite probable that the white guy that you're saying, oh, you're just a white guy, might be in fact Melungian. And since the fact is Melungians are some of the greatest minds on the planet, Melungian entertainers, Melungian politicians, Melungian inventors. No, I'm not talking about aliens. I'm not talking about lizard people. I'm talking about just humans who are black, white, and red, or black, white, and yellow, or black, white, and orange, or black, white, and whatever. Now those white men can't be hated on anymore. Now you have to find out some other way to hate on, because now the white man that you say, well, you're a white man, turns out that he's actually Melungian, a.k.a. black. Even worse, if we bring Melungian into modern language, we'll start questioning this entire division of white versus black. And if we really want to start delving into whose part this and whose part that, then we'll start noticing that, hey, oh, that's actually your cousin, distant cousin. By the way, Tom Hanks is the third cousin, fourth removed of Abraham Lincoln. Now, I have done a little trick to all of you. The picture that you have been seeing the entire video is not Abraham Lincoln. Now, I'm going to dispel the notion of who this guy actually is, and I'm a deeply embarrassed, ashamed of the people promoting it as being Lincoln. That's definitely not Lincoln. Lincoln is definitely a Moorish-looking guy. He did not look white. I know there's photographs of him, but you also have to remember, so since I'm a YouTuber, I deal with photographs a lot. I mean, thousands, hundreds of thousands of photographs, right? I understand that given the technology of the day, photographing somebody and making them come out looking white, it's very easy with the exposure of the actual film that was used. Now, the picture of the black man that you were seeing the entire video is not Lincoln. It was taken Thursday, 1820, September 21st. It's of Augustus Washington. Augustus Washington's birth in 1820 is celebrated on this date. He was an African-American abolitionist and photographer specializing as a daguerreotypist. Say that three times fast. From Trenton, New Jersey, he was the son of a former slave and a woman of South Asian descent. His mother died when he was young. A stepmother, also a former slave, raised him. Washington struggled to obtain schooling first in Trenton and later in Oneida Institute in Whiteboro, New York, Kimball Union Academy in New Hampshire, and Dartmouth College. Notice all of that is in the North, not the South. So this whole idea that the South is anti-black and the North is pro-black is a complete hogwash. In 1843, Washington moved to Hartford and opened a daguerrean studio to help finance education. Finishing school in 1847, he returned to Hartford, opens studio for a short period of time. During this time, many of his portraits were of political and social figures of the era and reflects his sentiment about slavery. In 1851, he expressed pessimism about prospects of blacks in American society in a letter to New York Tribune. In 1853, he immigrated to Liberia to work as school teacher, farmer, stone operator, and daguerreotypist. 1 year later, he expressed enthusiasm about his adopted land in a letter stating that, quote, I believe that I shall do 1,000 times more good for Africa. The last reference to Washington's work as a daguerreotypist dates from 1858. Washington never regretted his decision to emigrate to Liberia, and when he died in Monrovia on June 7, 1875, his death was marked as, quote, a severe loss to West Africa. Reference, National Portrait Gallery, Smithsonian Institute, P.O. Box 37012, Victor Building, Suite 8. 300 MRC 973 Washington DC 20013-7012. And there you have it. That should dispel any notion of who this person is. He's definitely black. His name is Augustus Washington, or his name was Augustus Washington. And he had no relation to Lincoln other than probably taking pictures of him at some time, at some point in his life. Now, the family of Lincoln will deny probably everything in this post, but I believe they're anti-Melungian. Thank you all for watching. Please like and please subscribe. I need to subscribe. And all this, everybody who's subscribed already, please click your notification bell. Thank you.